And let's talk to Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte. Good afternoon, Mayor.
Good afternoon po, and good afternoon to everybody watching ANC.
Yes, is it true that you sent an emissary to convey your apologies to the sheriff?
It was actually I, ma'am, who sent him to the hospital after the confrontation. So I think that's sorry enough. I asked also the doctor to admit him to the hospital, but he refused after first aid was given.
So sinasabi niyo po that by sending him to the hospital and getting him admitted, that is sorry enough?
Yes, ma'am, but I did not send anybody, I did not send an emissary to say sorry to him.
Why your reluctance to actually send apologies, ma'am? Why must they be in the form of sending him to the hospital? Why not an outright apology?
Because, ma'am, I was asking him to give me 2 hours because we were already preparing for this demolition yesterday. I sat down with all the people inside the area. I asked our city housing to sit down with the lawyers of the owner of the property. So everything was supposed to go smooth sailing. But what happened this morning when I asked him to wait for me and give me 2 hours because I am still in the relief operation, he was saying that he will not comply and he will just proceed with the demolition. That's why when my attention was called when the riot was starting already and one police was already in the hospital. That's why when I came here, medyo mainit na rin talaga yung ulo ko, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. And you're saying that justifies your beating up the sheriff?
I just punched him once, twice, ma'am. I did not beat him up. It does not justify what I did. But I will still stand by what I'm saying, that I was asking him for humanitarian reasons. He wait for me since we were already planning for this so that no riot will happen and the demolition will be executed peacefully. What I did not want to happen, ma'am, was what we see in television, where people are injured, where people die because of a demolition. That's why we were planning for this since yesterday. Mm-hmm. I was asking for him, you wait for me because the people will not listen to you. They will only listen to me.
Mm-hmm. But of course, Mr. The sheriff says that he was acting upon orders of the court and the court had not given any instructions for the demolition to be delayed.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. That was what he was saying. And when I asked also, he asked, he told the city housing officer to tell the judge, for the judge to call him. And then I told I called the judge also, ma'am. And then the judge refused to talk to his sheriff. That's why I said, okay, no problem. I will just ask the sheriff. Well, hindi ko naman po sinasabi na huwag mag-demolisyon. Ang sinasabi ko lang sa sheriff, antayin mo ako para hindi magkagulo at maayos yung demolisyon mo.
Mm-hmm.
Hindi niya ako maantay. What is 2 hours for him to execute properly his demolition? I am here to assist him and to assist the people.
Mm-hmm.
So what is 2 hours for him to decide, okay, we will wait for you for this to happen?
Uh-huh. But in any case, while it does not seem we're actually playing the video and it shows that you certainly punched him more than once, ma'am. Are you prepared for any sort of action to be taken against you as a result of this?
Yes, ma'am. No problem. If you want to file cases against him, he can do so. No problem.
Uh-huh. Have you heard from his supervisors or even the judge of the sala he represents?
No, ma'am. I haven't heard from him. He's my relative.
Uh-huh.
I haven't heard from him since this morning.
Okay. And you're saying, po, that you are prepared for charges to be filed against you?
Ma'am, fine. I heard that they're saying they're gonna file a contempt charge. That's not a problem with me.
All right. Mayor Sara Duterte, thank you very much for talking to us, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Maraming salamat.
Still in Davao, Vice President Jejomar Binay is visiting flood victims in the province. Binay will distribute relief.